Before I started modeling, actually, when I was 6 years old, I was diagnosed with an extremely rare illness called nephrotic syndrome minimal change disease. So I was actually homeschooled up until high school. And now the disease, it's 1 in 100,000, and it usually only ever hits boys. So actually mine was the first case in Canada for female.
Wow.
So it took 3 months to diagnose, and everything they had, which was very little at the time, had to come over from Europe. So not only was I homeschooled, but they gave me medication that made me swell like 2 or 3 times my normal size that I am right now. So my face was actually like moon-shaped, and I was homeschooled, so it's kind of like a, like really like a little reclusive child, even though like, I wanted to be out with everybody.
Yeah.
So that was, that kind of like, that's what my life revolved around up until I hit 16 years old, and then I went into remission, and then I had to go to high school. So I had like no social skills. I'd never really been to school. And I was like, here you go, high school. And I was like, what do I do here with all these people that, you know, I've never met? So my life revolved around, after going into remission, just trying to socialize and just survive high school, which is like the worst scenario to be thrown in for your first time.
Totally.
So that, and I just kind of stayed home a lot. Like, I was really into reading because I never had that interaction with people. So I didn't do movies, you know, I didn't do sleepovers. I was happy staying at home.
It's a very social industry. So how did you adjust to so much attention and so many people?
Yeah, it was hard. Like, I think one of my first shows I did was like a hair show, and I think what really caught me off guard was when everyone just got naked. And I was just like, oh my god, everyone's naked in this room. And I was like, am I supposed to get naked too? Like, and then I was, you know, as I'm looking around, I'm like, there are no change rooms. And I was like, but there's guys in here. And everyone's still naked. And like, that thing blew me away.
Mm-hmm.
How much being a model wasn't about you. It was about everything around you. And like, your naked body didn't faze anybody. But to me, I was just like, I still have a trouble sometimes, not that you'd believe me right now as I'm like talking away here, but I do sometimes just like, even just talking to bookers, I'm kind of like, mm-hmm. To the rest of the world, you know, people are like, oh, you're fine, you look fine, and you know, and then you go into modeling and they're like, this is too big, this is too small, you know, this isn't right, this isn't proportion, you should dress like this, wear this, and then I realize that it's a lot of, really gotta think about yourself. Sometimes I think, you know, like, is this anybody else's life? Does anybody else feel this way? You know, mm-hmm. when you're getting information about it, like if you booked a job and it seems really outrageous and really crazy, like sometimes I think that awkwardness comes back. So, I mean, it happens every once in a while, but I have to play it off like, yeah, I'm totally there, I'm there.